Everyone loves music. Listen as we learn about Newburgh's very own music man, Cornel McCormick.
What a pleasant day to be down on the riverbank. Oh, how I remember crossing this grand river many years ago. Yes, we lived just across the water in Henderson, Kentucky. From the time I was born in 1830 until I was about second or maybe fourth grade age. At about that time, my parents decided the little town on the Indiana side of the river held more opportunities for us. So we up and moved right here. Yes, this place called Newburgh truly was new back then. Come to think of it, Burg, B-U-R-G-H, means little town in German. So I guess the name Newburgh was just right for this new little town. And it was a very busy little town. Almost every day, 20 or more boats and steamships would dock here. 100 or more workers helped load and unload barrels of goods off and on the boats. Some barrels were stored in warehouses along the river edge. Local farmers and merchants brought their pork and wheat flour, lumber, tools, and coal to be sold down the river in other towns. It was a noisy, dusty, smelly place with horses, dogs, pigs, and cattle all about. I also recall loving school. Most of all, though, I loved music at home. We often sang and played musical instruments. Life was full of fun, and I loved Newburgh. Then something sad happened. I became an orphan. Yes, both my parents died when I was only about 12 years old. Life suddenly became more serious. After high school, I became a Newburgh school teacher. Teaching young children was good, yet I knew I needed to learn and earn more. I saved my money as best I could and went to business school in Louisville, Kentucky. I studied to become a bookkeeper because every successful business needs someone to keep good records of what is sold and how much money is spent. While in Louisville, I visited a museum to give my mind a rest from school. It was there I saw the most beautiful violins. I went back many times to admire them. I realized in addition to becoming a merchant, I also wished to make violins like those in the museum. My first job as a bookkeeper for a steamboat company was full of adventure. We traveled all the way down the Ohio and Mississippi rivers to New Orleans, Louisiana, and back many times. I saw and experienced so many interesting things. Islands right in the middle of the river, fast and dangerous water currents, thick forests on the riverbanks, flat plains with buffalo grazing, farmers using new steel plows to break the prairie sod, pioneers starting new towns, ports of large cities such as Memphis and New Orleans. I learned a lot on the river, but I never forgot about my dreams of owning my own business and making my own violins. So again, I saved my money and moved back to Newburgh. I opened a dry goods store on Water Street. Just about anything a family could need was available in my mercantile store. Groceries, tools, seeds for planting, boots, hats, blankets, even violins. Yes, in the back room of my store, I kept a pot of glue warm on the stove. Special wood for making violins was neatly stacked. And my special handmade tools for crafting the violins were nearby. I was happy and very busy. When you love what you do, you usually are successful. In time, I was able to build a beautiful home on State Street, 224 State Street. Here is home, so tall and strong and handsome, like the owner. I especially liked the little lookout at the very top. My family and I lived here over 35 years. In my spare time, I wrote songs for my violins and other musical instruments. I organized a Newberg band too, watching that band march down the street, playing my music as it passed by is a proud and cherished memory. By the way, down the street a block or two is another wonderful museum with a very special violin to admire. I hope many will take time to see it for themselves.
Corneal McCormick died in 1904, but his music lives on. Even after 100 years, interested persons continue to inquire about his musical instruments and compositions. The Newberg Museum is especially proud to have on display a McCormick violin, scores of his music, and even some of his handmade tools. We invite you to visit us at the Newberg Museum and see these treasures for yourselves.